One of the really handy features of ACE is the ability to recalculate itself. And there's a number of different reasons why you might want to recalculate an equation. Let's say, for example, you had a scheduled ACE calculation running and an interface was buffering while the calculation was running. And then at some point after the calculations had occurred, the interface buffer emptied out, the data was caught up, and the data is current. However, none of your ACE calculations are correct because the data didn't exist when the calculation was run on the server. It was in the interface's buffer. So, or maybe you're bringing data in from a foreign system, or there's a lot of reasons why you might want to perform a recalculation. It's very easy to do a recalculation. You just go into the ACE manager, and at any of the levels, depending on how much recalculation you want to do, server, executable, module, or context level, you simply right-click and say recalculate, or from the menus, and you're presented with the recalculation menu, where you specify the starting and ending times of the recalculation period. You can use PI timestamps in these dialog boxes in input areas. And there's also an interval option where you can specify the interval at which to do the recalculations. If you leave the interval option blank, we will simply use every archive event from the inputs to do the calculation. Keep in mind that if you are using the compression process on the PI server, there will potentially be less or many less values that ACE would have seen as opposed to the snapshot. When ACE is running a remember, it keeps a cache of the snapshots. When it does the recalculation, however, it doesn't have that luxury. It has to go into the archive. So even on a calculation where you're using snapshot events as triggers, you still may want to specify an interval if your source tag has had many values filtered out due to the compression process. There's also an automatic recalculation mode that you can set when you add or edit a context to a specific calculation. And it's at the bottom of that dialog box. And what this area does is list all of the input tags to a calculation. If you check one or more of these input tags, then any out-of-order archive events will calculate a recalculation. It'll trigger a recalculation, and that will force the recalculation for those events. Remember, out-of-order archive events are events that come in with a timestamp earlier than the current value or the current snapshot value. So we consider those out-of-order events. So if any of those recalculation tags that are checked have out-of-order events, it will trigger a recalculation of the ACE calculation that they're part of for those events. In order to demonstrate the recalculator, I've taken my ACE calculation offline for a number of hours, and you can see that's represented by the flat line in the trend here. I go back 8 hours, and you can see that I've roughly been out of service for 8 hours, and I don't have any data. However, I do have the source data, as demonstrated by the lower trend here. And what I want to do is I want to tell ACE to recreate the results of that calculation. So to do that, I simply go into my ACE manager and find the calculation. Now, you can recalculate at literally any level. You can recalculate at the server level. You can recalculate at an executable level. You can recalculate at a module level or at a context level. Because I only have one context here, I can recalculate at that level or the module level and still have the same results. You do want to be really careful here. You don't want to just recalculate the whole server if you don't need to. Unless my entire ACE server was down, I would not want to do that because the recalculation is fairly resource intensive, and it does take a while, and it does take up the resources on the server. So if I had an ACE server that was off in the corner doing just ACE, I might think about that. But if you're running ACE on your PI server, you really want to be very selective with the recalculation. And so all I need to do to recalculate is right-click, or I could use the menus, and select Recalculate. And I'm going to be presented with this very simple dialog box, giving me a start time and an end time for my recalculation. I'm going to go back about 10 hours for the recalculation, and my end time of now, I could specify hard-coded times in there if I wished. And I can specify an interval in seconds. Now, whether you use an interval or not may depend on exactly what resolution you want your calculation to run at. If I don't specify an interval in seconds, it's going to simply use the values from the archive to perform the recalculation. And I know for this source tag that I really have filtered out a lot using the compression process. The tag moves along very defined slopes for certain periods of time, and therefore compression does filter out quite a few values. So I'm going to use a 30-second interval to get a little bit higher resolution on my recalculation. Although you could argue that if it's only using values and interpolated values from the archive, then the interval in seconds may not be too meaningful. So you could look at that either way. But I'm going to use an interval for this demonstration, and I'm going to click OK. And if you flip right over to Process Book and you refresh it, you're going to notice that it looks like nothing happens. And it actually is happening in the background. It is a very resource-intensive process. It does take a few moments. The data will fill in. We just have to be a little bit patient. And at this point, I'm going to pause the video and return when it's complete. Okay, I've paused the video, and we were paused for about 20 seconds. It wasn't an extraordinary period of time. If there is a lot of data, however, it will take a little bit of time. And you can see that I have recreated my calculation using the ACE recalculator.